Tick, 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 do, do, do.
ToDoIst and TickTick are pretty great apps. Both of them are to-do list apps, but which one's better? I'm going to be the one to decide what you end up using because I have that power over you. Not really, I'm going to review the apps though. You want to check it out? Let's do it. When looking simply at pricing, we can see that TickTick versus ToDoIst, they both have free plans, which is great. And you can see that the features on a lot of these are going to be similar, but the premium version on TickTick maxes out at $2.4 a month, and then it's $3 a month if you are billed annually, and then $4 a month if you are billed monthly for ToDoIst. And then there's a $5 a month pricing options for Teams. But with the feature set, a lot of these are really similar. So the availability on ToDoIst and TickTick is very, very similar in that it's available on desktop, Mac, web, and they both have great mobile apps. And something I want to break down for this is the video itself may be comparing the two of these, but it's a surprising look at ToDoIst versus TickTick because TickTick actually has a lot of nice functionality that a lot of people don't bring up because they both have things like recurring tasks. As you can see, if I make a task in TickTick, I can do some very basic stuff like add priority, add subtasks, and there are obviously recurring tasks that can occur in this as well. With repeat options here. You can set things to certain times, and those are basic features that all of these different to-do list apps have. As you can see in this, if I do like natural language processing, so I can type in every Monday and it'll do a recurring task. And for TickTick, obviously you can just do things like daily, weekly, monthly, or a custom repeat weekly on Saturdays by due dates, by completion dates, specific dates. But something that's really nice with TickTick that's a feature that ToDoIst doesn't have is that you actually get a Pomodoro timer, which is something that I would be, you know, really surprised to see ToDoIst ever implement. It's just not something you'd think of for a to-do list app, but this is really nice. Another thing TickTick has that ToDoIst doesn't is that actually it has a calendar view. So unlike ToDoIst, you have calendar integration, but you don't have any sort of interconnectivity with a calendar in the app itself. So as you can see here, there are a list view, month view, day, 3 week, 3 day, and week views where you can pretty much connect things with a calendar view. Whereas in ToDoIst, what you're gonna have is a connection with Google Calendar, which I've done before, where essentially the task will get synced to your Google Calendar, but you won't actually get a calendar view in the app whatsoever. So this would show up here if I were to sign up to premium. However, I'm not on premium, so I can't show you that. However, I will say something that is lacking regarding TickTick versus ToDoIst is the integration piece. The Gmail integration for ToDoIst is exceptional. You can go into your Chrome browser and get a ToDoIst integration. And with this Chrome extension, if you're on an email, you literally just press this sign on the email and you can add anything like that to ToDoIst, which is a very nice integration that TickTick doesn't have. However, there actually is a Google Marketplace add-on for TickTick. So this means that it's not a Chrome extension, it's from the Google Workspace Marketplace. And this is a nice add-on because the Chrome extension not being available caused a lot of people to have issues with this app in comparison to ToDoIst, but that's a nice way to catch up in that race for which has better integrations. And unlike ToDoIst, where you can go in here and set up an integration with Google Calendar, you cannot do that in TickTick. So as you can see, the integrations that I have here are with things like this Google Calendar two-way sync. You can have Zapier, there's some Sama options, AkiFlow, Automate.io, but TickTick does not have nearly as much functionality there. So if we go to settings, there are not nearly as many integrations possible, but as you can see, there's the Eisenhower matrix, the Pomodoro timer option, the mini calendar is going to be for the premium plan, but you can see you have the Eisenhower matrix, which is actually interesting that ToDoIst does not have. So if I go here, the Eisenhower matrix is a very easy urgent and important, not urgent and important, urgent and unimportant, and not urgent and unimportant. So you can actually take tasks like these and move them between the four things, whereas you couldn't do that really in ToDoIst. There's not an option for that. However, there is a lot of other nice functionality, whereas if I were to make a new list here, you can see that there's actually going to be a Kanban view in both of these apps. So if I do this, you can actually switch it to a Kanban view and switch it between two different sections. So if I made a second section, you can switch through things like this, and you can do the exact same thing in ToDoIst. If I go into Side Hustle here, change this view to a board view, There's also grouping features as well in here, which is nice. Another nice thing about TickTick that's different than ToDoIst is that it has like a dedicated habit tracking section. So while you can track in ToDoIst the streaks that you're having on things and you can figure out what your daily goals are and whatnot, this has a specific habit tracking section. So like every day pushups, 100 pushups. You can do a frequency for every day, achieve it all goals, and then how long you want to do that for. So this can be something that's nice to have because you can check it off and be like, all right, how many day or what days have I done it to? It shows a weekly view of this, which I really like. And it's different than ToDoIst because ToDoIst just doesn't have that dedicated spot for it. Similar to how it doesn't have a dedicated Eisenhower Matrix spot or the Pomodoro app either. So if we go into TickTick here, we can see that there's actually a lot of nice functionality with you being able to add the Eisenhower Matrix, the focus section, a quick search on the bottom, or the habit section. So if we see here, you can add a specific amount of things on the bottom navigation here. So I obviously have this Eisenhower Matrix option, and if I want to get rid of that, I can go back to the habit one. And I think this is really nice because you have an app here that actually lets you do things like habit tracking, calendar management, and task management for only a few dollars a month. And I like the fact that it has a good premium version, but the free version has a Pomodoro app in it, which is kind of slept on. I mean, a lot of times when people are looking for good Pomodoro apps that are like connected between your computer and your phone, you don't really have that option. Like I use Flora, right? And Flora is only a iPhone option. But TickTick, it's kind of nice the fact that you can do all of these different things in one place. And even that Eisenhower Matrix feature that I keep bringing up is something that I think is different than ToDoIst for people who just want simple task management like that. And from a calendar management standpoint, while it may not be the same type of Google Calendar Sync, having it connected to a calendar view in general is awesome. And what's nice in this calendar view is it can have things like your habits, as well as if I take one of these and change it to today, it'll section things off between habits and the tasks that you have for the day in this calendar view as well. And this would give you more options for month, day, week, if you had that premium version as well. All these different functions that TickTick has versus ToDoIst make me genuinely question whether ToDoIst is actually the better of the two apps. However, I've used it much more than I had TickTick, even though TickTick was the first app I ever used. It's made a lot of strides since I used it back in 2018, I believe, and I think it actually might have a little bit more functionality than ToDoIst in some senses. However, I like the look and feel of ToDoIst a little bit better.
If you like this video, make sure to click on this one to see how you can improve your productivity even more.